Hello and welcome to this special episode on Indian classical music. We have been trying to learn various aspects in performances as well as in learning practical and theoretical aspect of various ragas. Today we have decided to discuss and learn Raag Asawari with well-known singer Vijay Koparkarji. Vijayji, welcome to this episode. We have always believed in Indian classical music that the tradition of learning from Guru, that is your guide in Indian music, is supposed to be the most important one. When the disciple goes and practically stays under the guidance and supervision of his Guru, that is his guide, it's a process of years and years to learn Indian classical music. In ancient time, this system was called as Gurukul system, where the disciple goes to the teacher, stays with him, and 24 hours he is in the atmosphere of music. Today, Vijayji, we are learning Raag Asawari from you.
Right.
And as usual, we would like to have some basics or basic features of Raag Asawari.
Yeah.
Could you please explain it to us?
Yeah. Asawari is a basic thought raag. Thought is a concept for the classification of ragas according to the notes of that raga. So in Asawari thought, Gandhar, Dhaivat and Nishad, they are Komal. Komal Gandhar, Komal Dhaivat, Komal Nishad is there. And it is having Gandhar and Nishad in ascending order, it is absent. And in descending order, all notes are there. That's why we can call Odav Sampurna. Jati is Odav Sampurna. This is the Asawari thought.
I think Asawari is quite an old raag. It has got a tradition of so many years.
Right.
Even
right.
In books which have been proved like a big guide to the music learners like Sangeet Ratnakar.
Right.
It's an ancient book.
It is a basic raag.
You have referred just now the basic structure and basic sur of this raag.
Right.
Could you please elaborate while singing on this ascending order, which we call it aroha, and descending order like avroha?
Yeah. I will explain the ascending and descending order, that is the aroha and avroha. Sa re ma pa da ra sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa. That means Rishabh and Madhyam, they are Shuddha, and Gandhar, Dhaivat, Nishad, they are Komal, and Gandhar, Nishad, they are absent in the ascending order. I will repeat it. Sa re ma pa da sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa.
In other types of Asawari, we would like to know that some music learners and music experts believe that other style, including Rishabh, is also there in ascending order.
Two schools are there. What I have explained just now, it's a Shuddha Rishabh Asawari, and the second one is a Komal Rishabh Asawari. The all structure is one and the same, except Rishabh. In one it is having Shuddha Rishabh, and in Komal Rishabh it is Komal Rishabh. It is also called as Asawari Todi. The Kirana Gharana, they sing the Komal Rishabh Asawari. They call it as Komal Rishabh Asawari, and the Gwalior and all other peoples, Jaipur also, they sing that second one is Shuddha Rishabh Asawari. And the basic structure and all the compositions, they are one and the same, except the Rishabh.
what is the time when this raag is basically sung?
Yeah, it is late morning. That means we can sing after 8 o'clock morning, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. So afterwards the sarang starts. After Asawari, then the sarangs comes.
And what are the feelings created by melody of this specific swar of Asawari?
Just like all other morning ragas, it is having serious mood. It is somewhat serious, and sad mood is also there.
Some sad notes are there.
Yeah, yeah.
Which creates some pathos also.
Yeah, definitely.
Now we would like to have some peculiar phrases, or how you develop this raag right from beginning for our learning community, because what our students need is not only the basic structure or not only the basic sur, but there must be some phrases in which they can just elaborate.
First raag. I will tell you the typical phrases of Asawari. The two phrases and compositions are there. Ma pa da ma pa ga re sa. This is a typical phrase for Asawari. Sa re ma pa dha ra pa dha ma pa re ma pa da ma pa ga ga re sa. Ma pa da 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 sa sa re ni da pa ma pa da sa re ni da da pa ma pa da ma pa ga re sa re ma pa da pa dha ma pa ga re ma pa da ma pa ga re sa. These are the typical things in Asawari, and I will explain other compositions also. Sa re ma pa ma pa da ma pa ma pa da ma pa ga re re ni da da sa ga re sa re ma pa re ma pa ni da pa ma pa da ma pa ga re sa ma pa da 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 sa sa re sa re ga re sa re ni re sa ga re ni da da pa ma pa da da sa sa re ni da da pa re ma pa ni da pa da da pa ma pa ga re sa re ma pa ga re.
One more thing comes to mind, that when you are avoiding rishab, what other notes are important, and which we call as a thaira, or we call it to take a pause on that specific note.
Right.
So what is the importance and interrelationship or other swar in these phrases?
In Asawari, the vadi samadhi, vadi is the dhaivat, that the important sur. Important note is Dhaivat, and second one Samvadi is Gandhar. So apart from Gandhar and Dhaivat, Pancham we can stay on that note. So there are three notes: Dhaivat, Pancham, and Gandhar. We can rest on that. Otherwise, Rishab, Madhyam, and Nishad has least important.
So which is the main sur in that melody which creates this sort of some sort of sad note, which is that
first one is the dhaivat sa re ma pa da ra ra pa re ma pa ni da pa da pa da ma pa re ma ga ga. this one is also important.
Gandhari also.
Sa re ma pa da ma pa ga ga re sa ma pa da 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 sa re ni re sa ga ra ni da da pa ma pa da da sa da pa ma pa ni da pa da ma pa ga ga re sa. So Daivat is the important, Daivat and Gandhar, and Pancham is also a sur where we can stay.
It's a beautiful explanation, I think, for the learning community as a whole. Vijayji, we would like to have further information about the Alankar or Palte and other combination of this particular melody.
Right. First thing, I should explain the second one, that Komal Rishabh also.
Yes.
I think it is important because it is a part of Asawari, and it is also a popular raag, which is called Asawari, Komal Rishabh Asawari. So in comparison, I should explain that also, because some change in the ascending order is there because of Komal Rishabh. Sa re ma sa re ma pa da da pa dha ma ga re sa re ma pa ni da ma ga re ma ga re ga re ni da sa sa re ma pa da da ma ba da sa sa re re ga re ni da ma ba da sa re ni da ma ba ni da dha ma ga re. So in Komal Rishabh, ma ba da ma pa, this phrase is very less we use that. Ma ba ni da dha ma ga re sa re ma pa da dha ma ga re ga re ni da da sa. So while singing, we should take care that it is very close to Bilas Khani Todi. In Bilas Khani, it goes sa re ga pa. But in Komal Rishabh Asawari, it goes sa re ma pa. Only this
one note,
this
difference, yeah, is there.
Yeah. Sa re ga pa ga ba da ni da ma ga re ma ga re ga re sa. This one is the Bilas Khani. Now Komal Rishabh, sa re ma ma ba da sa re ni da ma ga re sa re ma pa da dha ma ga re ga re. And because of Komal Gandhar, it is also called as Asawari Todi.
Yes.
Ga re sa, this comes in Todi. So it is also called as Asawari Todi.
What would be the next step for the students to begin with various phrases?
Yeah. First, we should study the thaat concept, the which are the ragas comes under this thaat. So all the Bahaduri Todi, the Lakshmi Todi, Anjani Todi, and this Jaunpuri, Devgandhar, Gandhari, they comes under Asawari thaat.
Asawari itself, yeah, is a thaat.
Huh.
Out of these 10 thaats,
yeah.
Asawari itself, so, is a main thaat.
When we consider as a thaat, so all these ragas, they come under the Asawari thaat.
Vijayji, when we are discussing Raag Asawari as a thaat,
right,
it comes to my mind that there are several other thaats also in South Indian music. So can you just explain something about that?
The similar concept is there in South Indian music also, but they have 72 thaats.
72?
And we, Uttar Hindustani music, we have 10 thaats.
And Asawari is considered as a major, major thaat in that.
Yeah.
We would like to have some knowledge on other ragas also under thaat Asawari.
Right.
Could you please elaborate on that?
Yeah. In Asawari thaat, all the Bahaduri Todi, Anjani Todi, Lakshmi Todi, and the Abheri is there. and the Jaunpuri, Dev Gandhar, Gandhari, and Komal Rishabh Asawari. These all comes, and many ragas there, all comes in the Asawari thought. First, we have to study the Jaunpuri, Dev Gandhar, and Gandhari, because they are very closer.
Similar.
To the, very similar. A very minute difference is there. So, I think one by one I will explain what is the difference. First, we will see the Jaunpuri. Jaunpuri is one and the same. Only the thing in Aroha, that is in ascending order, Komal Nishad, is present.
Mm.
And we take Komal Nishad. Sare ma pa dha da pa ma ba da ni sa re ni re sa ga ra ni da da pa ma ba da ni sa da pa ma ba ni da pa da pa da ma pa re ma pa ga ga re sa re ma ba da ma ba da ni sa da pa ma ba da ni sa ni da pa ma pa ni da pa da ma pa re ma pa ga ga re sa. So it is very similar. Only in Aroha we take Komal Nishad. Gandhari is a rag where we take Komal Rishabh also. Sa re ma pa da da pa ma pa da ma pa ga re sa. Sa re ma pa da pa ma pa ga re sa. Sa re ma pa ma pa da pa da ma pa ga re sa. This was the Gandhari and Komal Rishabh Asawari. Sa re re ma ma pa ma ba da da pa da da sa re ni re sa ga re ni da pa ma ba ni da pa ma ba da da pa dha ma ga re sa re ma pa ni da ma ga re ma ga re ga re sa. The typical bandish for this one. Kalana parat mohe Komal Rishabh Asawari. Kalana parat mohe Kalana parat mohe Tumare daras bina Avo shauma more madirva Avo shauma more madirva Kalana parat Kalana parat mavarasa sa re ga re ni da ma ba da sa re ni da ma pa ni da da ma ga re sa re ma pa da ma ga re ga re sa ka la na pa ra. This was the Komal Rishabh Asawari. And Dev Gandhar is there, where both Gandhars, Shuddha Gandhar and Komal Gandhar, it is having Gaud Anga. Gaud, some sort of Gaud is there. It is added with the Asawari. Re ma pa ni ni da pa da pa da ma pa re ma pa ga ga re re sa re ga ga ma ma pa da ma pa ga re sa re ma pa ni ni da pa da ma pa ga re sa re ga ga ma ma pa dha ra pa ma pa ga re sa. I will give you the example.
This Gandhar is different.
Bara jore na karo re kanai, bara jore na karo re kanai, Jamuna ke ghat paniya jo bharan, gagari mori girai, mose kar ke larai, bara jore na karo re kanai, जमुना के घाट पनिया जो भरन गगरी मोरी घिराई मोरे कर के लराई बर जोरी न करो रे कना सारे रवा मा नी रवा मा बरवा मारे सारे गा गा मा मा बरवा मा बगारे साबर जोरी न करो रे कना.
This Gandhar is completely different in this family that is specifically mentioned in
that. Shuddha Gandhar is
Shuddha Gandhar is
there. It is in that the composition is typical. Sa re ga ga ma ma pa ra ma pa ga re sa. All is the Asawari is there.
Coming back to our basic Asawari, we would like to again have for the learning community. The basic structure of Asawari again. And if you can explain further phrases.
I will explain every note, how important it is and how specifically it is taken in the composition of Asawari. First one is the Sharja, Sa. Sa is important, there is no problem. The Rishabh. Rishabh is present in Aroha. No Nyas is there, no stay. We can't stay on Rishabh. Sa re ma pa, re ma pa da ma pa ga, sa re ma pa ga. So re is important, but we can't stay on that. And in Komal Rishabh Asawari, the different composition is dha ma ga re, sa re ma pa dha ni da ma ga re, dha ma ga. Mapada mapa phrase is absent in Komal Rishabh Asawari. It dhama pancham is absent in that phrase only. Dhama gare gare sa. So this is the difference in Rishabh. In Komal Rishabh it is Komal and it comes like dhama gare. And now the Gandhar. Gandhar is a samvadi sur. It is very important. Every lower phrase it stays on Gandhar. Ma pa da ma pa ga, sa re ma pa ga, sa re ma pa da da pa dha ma pa ga, ga re sa, sa re ma pa ga re sa. So it is a typical Gandhar. Paga dhama paga ga re sa. Now the madhyam. Madhyam, you can't stay on that. No nyas is there. But in aroha, it is important. Aroha and avroha. Sa re ma pa ma pa da da pa. A typical phrase. Ma pa da ma pa. Sa re ma pa ma pa da pa. Ma pa da ma pa re ma pa ma pa ni da pa dha ma pa. So in repetition, in every composition, madhyam is there. So it is important. Sa re ma pa da ma pa ga re sa. Now the pancham. Pancham is a nyasa sur, just like Gandhar, Daivat and Pancham. The three are the important and nyasur. Sa re ma pa dha pa re ma pa ma pa da da pa dha da pa ma pa sa re ma pa da da ma pa da sa sa da da pa ma pa ni da pa dha ma pa ga ga re sa. So pancham, we can stay on that note. Now the Daivat. Daivat is a important sur, vadi sur. So every in every composition, Daivat is there. Sa re ma pa ma pa da da pa da da pa ma pa re ma pa ma pa da da pa ma pa da sa re ni re sa ga re ni da pa ma pa sa da da pa ma pa ni da pa da pa da ma pa ga ga re sa. So Daivat is a important, it is Vadi Sur. Now the Komal Nishad, it is absent in ascending order. Ma pa dha sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. So in Aroha, Komal Nishad is not there. And typical one composition is there, it is in Asawari. Ma pa da da sa sa ni da pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa ni ni da pa ma pa. In tan it's come sa re ma pa da pa ma pa da sa sa re re sa ni da pa ma pa sa ni da pa ma pa ni ni da pa ma pa da pa ma ga re sa sa re ma re ma pa ma pa da pa da sa ni sa sa re sa ni da pa ma pa da sa ni da pa ma pa ni ni da pa ma pa ni ni da pa. This is a typical phrase for Komal Nishad. Ma pa ni ni da pa ma pa da pa ma ga re sa. This is the fine study of Raag Asawari. In conclusion, Gandhar, Daivat and Pancham, they are the Nyas Sur. Daivat is Vadi, important. Second one, Gandhar, is Samvadi. That's all the Asawari says.
I think the learning community should keep all these things in mind when we are learning something about Indian classical music. It's not simple to just listen the basic structure and start singing. Rehearsing it and practice makes the student perfect. As I referred in the beginning of this episode, electronic multimedia is a tool to get you introduced to the Indian classical music. We are trying to give you some basic information, basic structure, technical aspect, grammar of Indian classical music. But it's always better to be in touch with your guru, because nothing in this world can be compared or can be given as an alternative to a human being called guru. That is your guide in Indian classical music. We are fortunate enough to get guru like Vijayji Koparkar today. Vijayji, I would request you one thing at the ending note of this episode. We would like to have some lingering notes of the same raag in our mind on the ending note of this episode. If you could end up some musical note of Raag Asawari, that would be enhancing our knowledge.
Sa re ma re ma pa ma pa da pa ma pa da pa ma ga re sa sa re ma pa ni ni da pa ma ga re sa sa re ma pa da sa sa re sa ni da pa ma pa ni ni da pa ma pa re ma re ma pa ma pa ni ni da pa ma ga re sa sa re ma pa da pa ma pa da sa sa re ga re sa ni da pa ma pa da sa re re sa ni da pa ma pa sa ni da pa ma pa ni ni da pa re ma pa ma pa ni ni da pa ma ga re sa a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a a